from Illinois Center and the John Howard Society. I was just about to, and I don't see her now, I was going to facilitate an introduction for Daryl. Sewer Girl's name is Lorraine Hewlett from Northlands. She's affected by that disaster down there, so there you go. Lorraine, that's Daryl. So, there you go. My question will go to Yellowknife Center and to Cam Lake. There is some proposed federal legislation currently in Parliament, collectively known as the Omnibus Crime Bill, which will drastically affect Aboriginal populations, make people more unemployable as we increase our prison population by 15%, and make pardons more difficult to obtain, and crack down hard on youth so that we can hang them with a criminal record for the rest of their lives. Mm-hmm. At a quick glance, because this will be imposed on the territory, correctional custody alone in 1 year would be about $6 million, not to mention the capital costs, in addition to the court costs. So where, if elected, where will you be making budget cuts to come up with the millions and millions of dollars that are about to be imposed by the federal government on us here in the territory?
Thank you for your question. We'll begin with the Yellowknife Center. Robert Hawkins, go ahead.
Thanks, Lydia. Well, I guess first of all, I'll just say that I don't believe locking people up is the best or most long-term solution because, as it's been said many times, the United States would be the safest place in the world if that's how they solve their problems. The fact is the federal government is coming forward with this type of initiative that I think is not the right solution. And I think on any solution that's imposed on the territorial government, they have to be the financial solution to that problem. That doesn't mean I agree with what they're doing, but if they're going to impose something like that, we have to take a territorial stance and probably work in arm with our other two territories who probably can't afford the federal government solution either and say, no, we're going to refuse until you fund us properly. But this is also another type of problem, and you mentioned about the youth, which I think is very timely in this question. With my campaign office downtown, one thing I've really noticed is in the evening is how many youth are out there and probably need better direction. And one of the issues that we should be working on is getting social workers on our streets in the night to help talk to these youth and see if we can direct them to a better path. So that's time, so sorry. I wish I could say more. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Arlene Hashay with the Yellowknife Center.
I obviously don't support the Omnibus bill because it doesn't work and it's been proven not to work. I have found that the NWT aren't the best negotiators, primarily because we always get stuck with the bill. So just as CMHC negotiated the downloading of, you know, the housing to the NWT with, you know, disappearing funds in years, I suspect the same thing will happen federally. So the first job is to oppose it and join with the other territories and provinces and oppose that bill. The second thing is to invest in family support type programs and treatment programs and mental health outreach kind of options that really deal with the core issues. Please don't give us social workers on the street. We need family support people to make sure that children are in their homes, not on the street. Mm-hmm. So there are really innovative kinds of solutions, including the Family Violence Action Plan that we need to implement. And the plans are done, we're ready to go. The GNWT is not going to invest in that.
Thank you. And thank you. Our candidates for Cam Lake, beginning with Brian Sutherland.
Thank you. I would agree with everything that Hawkins said. I don't support the bill. I do support prevention as opposed to locking people up. I also think if they were to force that on us, that they would be paying for it. If that's not true, then we'd have to look at avenues to recoup that cost. With the TTF, every time that's formulated, as they add costs that we have to do, would those be calculated in there? But the bottom line is I don't support the Omnibus bill, and I would support, if it was had to be implemented here, that the federal government should be paying for it. Thank you.
Thank you, and Dave Ramsey, Cameron.
Thanks very much, Jocelyn. Thanks for the question, Lydia. Obviously, you know, we're on the election trail right now. The new government's going to come in sometime later this month. And I think this is going to be a question that's going to be front and center. You know, what do we do? And others have said it. I think we need to work with our territorial counterparts in the Yukon and Nunavut. It's going to have similar type of impacts on them as well. But the bottom line is, I think we need to get tough on crime. I mean, we have far too much crime. When you read the newspaper lately, you know, June was the most violent month on record. Then July became the most violent month on record. We've got people committing violent crimes in our territory for 30, 35 times in a row, and then ultimately they end up killing somebody. I mean, we need to get tough on crime. Now, whether or not this is ultimately the answer or not, that remains to be seen. And certainly, I think the new government has to analyze the impact that this will have on the correction system here in the Northwest Territories. But we need to get tough on crime. Thank you.
All right, thank you. And thank you for your question.